So the task to perform this one we are going to take as MATLAB program to perform 4-point DFT, where the discrete time sequence is represented by x of n. It is having the four elements 1, 1, 2, 3 here. So hereupon we have to make the use of the function FFT, and we have to also sketch the corresponding magnitude and phase spectrum here. Whereas after this task is accomplished here, we have to also carry out its inverse FFT here, or the DFT first of all we can say here, with the frequency domain sequence as the input here. IFFT will be the function here, and here also we have to extract the time domain sequence here. So to complete these two tasks, let us switch to the MATLAB environment. So capital N will hold the value 4 here. Next to that, the given discrete time sequence to be operated for the 4-point DFT is x of n is equal to 1123 here. So this signal is to be generated here. So I just mentioned input sequence generation. We into the input sequence, we take the variable xn and assign array to it. So this array will hold the values 1, 1, 2, 3 here as provided into the program statement. Now as we are going to make the DFTs computed by the FFT commands here, so here we shall be simultaneously displaying it onto the command window. So I shall be mentioning DISP, and here I shall be specifying a string here. The string will print DFT of the sequence x of n here, and here it can be holded by capital XK, that is computed by using the FFT command, and the inputs are xn, the input variable of the discrete sequence here, and capital N holding the value 4 here. So here we are not going to provide a semicolon, as we have to display the corresponding values onto the command window here. So after carrying out the forward TFT here, we have to also plot its corresponding magnitude and phase spectrum. So for magnitude spectrum here, we shall be displaying the magnitude related coefficients onto the command window. So now DISP, and the string here I am writing to be the magnitude sequence is ending it with the semicolon. Now there should be a variable that computes the magnitude sequence here. So here we specify it with the variable MAG capital XK here, and that is computed by having the absolute value from the frequency domain version of the given discrete time sequence here, so that it is nothing but capital XK here. So this is also not to be ended with the semicolon. Now after giving the values of magnitude sequence onto the command window, the phase values, the angle values are to be also displayed here. So for that purpose, DISP, and here we shall be mentioning the phase sequence. And for the phase sequence, we take the variable capital PHA, then capital XK here. And this is computed by having the MATLAB syntax angle, and to this we have provided the input as capital XK here. So this is also not to be closed with the help of semicolon. So the three parts are to be displayed onto the command window. First is the DFT of the input sequence, then the magnitude sequence, and then the phase sequence here. So after this, now let us carry out the inverse transformation. So as we have seen, the second task is to perform the IDFT by the function command IFFT here. So for that purpose, we go for the display here, and here we mention this is the inverse DFT of the sequence XK. So XK is the frequency domain representation of the sequence. For that, we have to perform the inverse transformation. So here the display commands can be ended with the semicolon here, and now here we shall be holding the time domain sequence values with the help of the variable that we write xn here, or we can take capital X here. So though it is not the usual practice to make the use of capital casing for the time domain sequence, it will be a conflict with whatever the variable we have taken already, small xn, the original one. So capital xn, n to represent the discrete time. So we are going to make IFFT command in use, and the input is capital XK here. So this is also not to be closed with the help of semicolon here. Now for the purpose of plotting, we are of course going to make the use of subplot commands here. So we require the variable corresponding to the discrete time as well as the frequency here. So for the discrete time here, small n is always the variable we make the use of, that we can initiate at the zero with the changes of interval by 1 up to capital N minus 1. So this is the declaration of the discrete time vector we can see here. Whereas for the frequency, we can declare the variable WK here. So WK can also be initiated at 0 with the intervals of 1 up to capital N minus 1 here. So this is also ended with the semicolon. Now it's a part of plotting to purpose of display here. So we make the use of subplot command, and as we want to display the forward as well as the inverse transformed versions, here we shall be taking the two rows and the two columns. So the total 4 subplot cells there it will be. So I mentioned 2, 2, the first cell I'm going to assign here. So in the first cell, as we are going to make the use of discrete domain, the command is stem, and the input is small n as the discrete time variable along with xn. So this is the original discrete time sequence here. So thereupon we shall be providing the title here. So the title is input sequence, and it's a part of labeling. So x label, we provide here the variable small n, then y label to the y axis here, we mention it to be xn here. So the original input discrete time sequence is plotted into the first cell here. Now we go for the second cell here. So I just mentioned subplot, thereupon I mentioned 2, 2, the second subcell here. I make the use of stem command here, and here we provide n, capital xn. So capital xn is the one that we have obtained by taking the inverse Fourier transformation here. So IFFT command we have used. So this way we can compare the first cell to the second cell. First one is the original one, second that is obtained after having the transformation and the inverse transformation. So here we shall be writing the title. So within a pair of parentheses and a pair of single quotes, I shall be mentioning inverse DFT sequence, and then part of labeling. So X label, we provide small n as the variable, whereas Y label here we provide capital XN here. Now out of the four cells, the two cells have been assigned. Now let us go for the next cell subplot here. It will be 2, 2, 3 it will be. And now again the use of stem command here, and as we have to make a plot of frequency values here, we have to correspondingly make the magnitude and the phase sequence values plotted here. So it will be the frequency vector WK comma, it will be for the magnitude here capital MAG capital XK here, and the title here we provide magnitude spectrum. Now it's a part of labeling, so X label we provide small k, then Y label we provide capital MAG XK here. Now the last subcell is to be plotted here. So for that purpose we mention it's a subplot 2, 2, 4 it will be, and we make the use of stem command. Again it will be the frequency vector WK comma, for the phase sequence we write capital PHA capital XK variable here, and the title here we provide the title within a pair of parentheses and a pair of single quotes, it is phase spectrum. And lastly the labeling to this plot, X label is the parameter K, and then Y label. So for Y label we shall be writing capital PHA capital XK here. So this will complete the task here. We save it with the name program 1_, here we have 1_29 here. .m will be the file extension. So these were the two tasks we have embedded, the forward as well as the inverse transformation for the given discrete time sequence x of n having the elements 1, 1, 2, 3. So let us execute it by running the program. So as we run this particular program, onto the command window, first of all we go for DFT of the sequence x of n is. So it is getting the input x of n to the transform domain here. So capital XK that holds up to the four elements, column 1 up to column 4 here. So it has the representation into the complex domain here, real as well as the imaginary portions, with the help of I or J if you treat, that is represented here. Now taking the absolute of the above coefficients here, the magnitude sequence is plotted here. The values have been given, say 1, 2.2361, 1 and 2.2361 again. The phase spectrum by deriving the angular values from the DFT coefficients here, that is 0, 2.0344, 3.1416, minus 2.0344 here. And lastly, the inverse Fourier transform, the inverse DFT by making the use of function IFFT. So the value is 1123. So we get back to the program statement. Here it is x of n 1123 that we have successfully recovered here. Now what is the MATLAB figure that has been displayed here? So it is nothing but subplot. So four subplots have been utilized here. Into the first cell we can see here the input sequence. So in the input sequence here we have small n values onto the horizontal axis here, whereas the amplitudes have been plotted here. The first element here, it is circled here. Here you can see it has the y amplitude value to be equal to 1. For the second element it is also 1. For the third element here it is 2, and for the fourth element it is also plotted here to be the 3 here, the highest value here. So this is the input sequence into the first cell, and into the second cell here we have the inverse DFT sequence here. So after the recovery, you can see both of the sequences are the same, 1 1 2 3. So at the second row here we have the magnitude spectrum plotted, and in the last we have the phase spectrum plotted.